Okay, Annie is going to make her famous chocolate chip cookies now.
Okay, so this recipe is just a modified version of the Nestle Toll House recipe, but there are a few changes. So first, I start with my KitchenAid. Mine doesn't have a name like Christina's, but it's my friend.
You know what's sad? I don't remember what I named it.
Roxy.
Roxy, there we go.
Oh, wait, it's I sad need the that paddle.
You, it's sad that you know more than I do.
Well, I love KitchenAids. Okay. So I start with 1 stick of the butter-flavored Crisco. You gotta make sure you get all the extra little bits. Yeah. Okay. And then I put in 1.5 cups of brown sugar. Lots of recipes call for half brown sugar and half white sugar, and I just do all brown. I like it better that way. And I firmly packed it before I put it in the cute little bowl. The bowl makes it look nicer. So I'm just going to cream that together. Okay, that's probably good. And now I'm gonna add 2 eggs. This looks so Martha-ish. There must be a little chunk of brown sugar in there. You can hear it. Okay. And to that, we're gonna add a teaspoon and a bit of vanilla. So there's no exact science for it. You just do a teaspoon and then some, and maybe a little more.
I love vanilla. I think you can never have too much of it.
Yeah. The key to this recipe is you put in extra vanilla and extra salt.
Oh.
Because who doesn't like extra salt?
So now it's a little more pasty.
Yeah. Okay. So now you've got all of your wet ingredients together. Okay. And now I mix all of my dry ingredients together first, and then I put it in all as a combination. So I do 2 1/4-ish cups. The flour, again, it's not an exact science.
It's really loosely packed. Like, you didn't even use a knife to, you know, lop off the extra on top, so. Edit that little part out.
Yeah, I was like, people at home are going to be appalled that I used the same thing. So, I use 1 teaspoon of baking soda. And then 1 teaspoon of salt, but I make it kind of like a mounded teaspoon because you want to get some extra salt, but you don't want to go overboard. I think I went a little overboard, so there we go. Okay, and then I just kind of like mix that all together. You can use a knife, but why dirty a knife when you can just use this? Okay. And then I take my measuring cup. And while it's mixing, I just mix in about 1/4 cup of the dry mixture at a time. What is going on?
It's having fun there.
Yeah, it knows that it has an audience.
It's a little nervous.
Yeah. Oh.
Has it ever done that before?
No. We're probably going to get comments from people of like, oh, this is what you should do when your KitchenAid is acting up.
Okay, so let's see what's happening in there.
There's got to be a chunk of brown sugar. I've got money on it.
Maybe the bowl's just loose. No, it's like on there.
It's
so weird. Is the paddle not on all the way or something, maybe? No, it would come off.
Take a look at your dough and see what the consistency is, and if it's a little too wet, you can always add more flour. But if you get it too dry from the beginning, then that's not good. So that's why I always hold back a little bit on the flour, and your maximum is going to be 2.5 cups, but you can always add. You can't take away.
Taste.
I think it's good.
Oh, sorry.
That's right. Okay. I like to fold in my chocolate chips by hand because some people say that you'll break the chocolate chips with the mixer. You won't, or at least I don't. But I just like to do it by hand because then I have better visibility of them. You can cut out.
Make sure they're evenly distributed. Yeah.